The Divine Nine Dragon Cauldron. Chapter 26. He looked to the side and saw a group of martial artists standing in a circle, looking at an empty corner in the shop. There were people fighting in the middle, causing a commotion. It looked as though it had been going on for some time, but Su Yu had not noticed. Shopkeeper, aren't you afraid of your shop being wrecked? Su Yu mocked. With the size of this shop, it should have powerful supporters. It was strange that people would dare cause trouble here. A wry smile spread across his face. That depends on who is doing the damage. The shopkeeper sighed helplessly. They have been here for quite some time. One of the training institute's gold student, said to be ranked third, was challenged publicly by a white armor guard from the palace of Xianyu Prefecture. The shopkeeper shook his head and said, white armor guards from the Xianyu Prefecture palace are powerful level 4s of the martial path at least. How is a gold student an opponent? Take a look over there. That was appalling. At the Xianyu Prefecture Palace, the guards were divided into black armor and white armor. Black armor guards, who Su Yu saw once, were ferocious. Each were formidable level 5s of the martial path. White armor guards, level 4s of the martial path, were the core strength that upheld order in the Xianyu Prefecture. A soft groan was heard, and someone was knocked to the ground. A gold student of the training institute, no big deal. Among the bystanders, there was a 20-year-old white armor guard. His arms were crossed and his white armor emanated dazzling radiance, complementing his tall young body. Standing beside the white armor guard, Li Minghao smiled, his eyes elated as he coldly watched the person lying on the ground. Lu Xuan, when I was first driven away from the team, I thought you had a great opportunity. It seems you haven't made much progress. Struck down on the ground, Lu Xuan was badly battered. A trickle of blood flowed from the corner of his mouth. With no strength left his body, he laughed bitterly inside. He had just returned from the Twilight Mountains. Upon entering the shop, he unexpectedly ran into Li Minghao and his cousin, Li Jinshun. Li Minghao had been brooding over his failure to get the universe's miracle mineral plant from inside the cave guarded by the demonic beasts. He was disgruntled, causing him to challenge Li Jinshun. Li Jinshun was a terrifyingly strong level 4, how could he compete with that? Lu Xuan suffered silently. He got up with much difficulty, clenched his fists dejectedly, and clutching his abdomen, he slunk through the crowd and left. At that moment, he found Su Yu standing outside the crowd, with his fists clenched. First, he was startled, then he hastily shot him a look, wanting to leave quickly. He'd already suffered retaliation from Li Minghao, now Su Yu. Hey, Su Yu, so you are here too. Unfortunately, Li Minghao's sharp eyes discovered Su Yu's presence. With loathing, Li Minghao snapped, cousin, it's him. With his cold eyes shooting daggers, Li Jinshun separated the crowd and approached Su Yu. He narrowed his eyes, it was you who wounded Minghao. Very well, I, Li Jinshun, challenge you. Prepare to fight. With a calm expression, Su Yu turned a deaf ear and walked away. He was not interested in a meaningless match. The bystanders shook their heads slightly. Li Jinshun is such a big bully, a level 4 challenging a level 3, it's a one-sided match. Is it because those two have no powerful supporters? Do you think Li Jinshun has the guts to challenge Qin Feng and Fan King Zhu? Li Jinshun remained unmoved even after he heard the whispers around him. Seeing how Su Yu ignored him, Li Jinshun, dazzling in white, made a brazen move. Fight or no fight, I have the final say. Whether you choose to fight or not, you'll have to fight either way. Li Jinshun's hands turned into claws and ferociously lunged at Su Yu's back. Su Yu frowned. This person was a true example of a bully always being a coward. He even resorted to a sneak attack. With a tap of his toe, Cloud Shadow was unleashed. Li Jinshun was only one claw away from a successful sneak attack and yet Su Yu did not even glance back. His figure gracefully floated away, like the shadow of a white cloud. Like duckweeds drifting with river waves, he lightly leaped forward and casually avoided a strike. Li Jinshun stared in disbelief. True, he only used a third of his strength, but how could the other party be so relaxed? Hey, I couldn't tell before, but it appears you know a thing or two. Not bad, so I won't hold back. Li Jinshun coldly smiled. Mountain Fist. Li Jinshun suddenly unleashed the strong inner strength of a powerful level 4. An invisible force field caused all the bystanders to fall back one after another. Hiss. Li Jinshan is so vicious, seizing the opportunity to be so heavy-handed. When beating up Lu Xuan, he didn't even use all his strength, but now he's giving it all. Su Yu is going to suffer horribly. The mountain fist was a medium-level cultivation technique. A fist struck, its shadow overlapped. Strong and powerful, the pressure made the air hum. Earth-shattering strength headed towards him. Su Yu's brows slightly creased as his right foot lashed out. The robust leg, transformed by the jade fire marrow, unleashed a mighty power. This leg displayed strength that was beyond logic. The two men each took three steps backwards. Su Yu's face registered no change in color, his expression calm. On the other hand, Li Jinshan secretly took a deep breath and shook out his numbed fists. Such strong physical strength and fast leg technique. Li Jinshan muttered. 9 times out of 10, a level 4 could subdue a level 3, but this match was a draw. Most importantly, the other side only used physical strength, and not any cultivation technique. Leaming how dumbstruck and pale, he found it hard to believe. Su Yu could actually block my cousin's blow. Lu Xuan also dared not to believe. When did Su Yu attain such intense strength? They had to know Li Jinshan and Qin Feng had the same level of strength. Are you really the Silver King? Li Jinshan found it incredulous. How could a silver student be so tough? Su Yu asked indifferently. No more fighting. Li Jinshan's face turned pale and then crimson. He was overbearing and haughty, and forced the challenge on the other party. How could he cower now? Boy, don't be rampant. You do not know the strength of a level 4. Li Jinshan snorted and with a growl, a stream of pure energy flow surrounded his arms. Lu Xuan's expression greatly changed. Su Yu, go quickly. He is going to use vital energy.
You're no match for him.
Vital energy could only be condensed in the realm of Lever 4. Entering level 4, one could cultivate vital energy in the body. The energy was pure and full of explosive power. Vital energy played a crucial role in enabling a level 4 to steadily subdue a level 3. Mountain Fist. The formidable power of the same move, using vital energy, could more than double. The air trembled and was so turbulent that the punch looked blurry. A wave of horror came crashing through. Su Yu was fearless. Tempest. His right foot lashed out. When amid the sweeping cold wind, the lashings of icy air made one feel as if they were surrounded by blades. The leg was not even straight yet, and cold air was already sweeping across. White cold mist could even be seen glistening at times. Bam! Once again, the two men took a step back. Su Yu still appeared relaxed. But Li Jinshan was different. One could see that his fist was covered in frost. The piercing cold blocked the fist's inner strength circulation, meaning vital energy was unable to flow. A look of shock flashed across his face. Li Jinshan felt slightly chilled in his heart. No more fighting, Su Yu breezily asked again. Li Jinshan vexed, you think I'm afraid of you? The two people figures intersected and staggered like shadows, wave after wave. Mountain Fist. Tempest. One move, two moves, three moves, four moves, five moves, six moves. After some time had passed, the two men had exchanged more than 100 moves. That's Su Yu, is he really the Silver King? So powerful, almost close to the Gold King. Compared to the Gold King, Su Yu is still far behind, but he's comparable to the second-ranked Qin Feng. After being kicked in the chest by Su Yu, his body hurled backwards and crashed onto the ground. Li Jinshan violently spurted out a mouthful of blood. Looking intently at it, there was actually cold mist with the blood. His whole body, especially his fists, was chilled and pale, shivering uncontrollably. Li Jinshan's face looked terrified. Every contact with his leg technique caused the cold air in his body to drop another degree. Over time his body began to slow down and he was finally defeated. With his right leg withdrawn, Su Yu's strength was slightly diminished, but not by much. His strong body, surpassing ordinary people's, provided him with an endless stream of physical strength. Lightly glancing at Li Jinshan, Su Yu shook his head and said, "The white armor guard of the Xianyu Prefecture Palace is only so-so. At the very least, he can't even compare to the Silver King." Li Minghao looked frightened and carefully pressed against the wall to slink behind Li Jinshan. He pathetically lent an arm to support him and they left with their tails in between their legs. Su Yu was too strong. So strong that even Li Minghao would not dare think of revenge. Leaving everyone in awe, Su Yu walked away. At the restaurant, a youth with big eyes, thick brows, and a youth with a cool, detached expression and a head full of silver hair quietly watched the entire course of events. Ha ha,
shall we?
It seems we meet the silver kid from the depository of scriptures again. It looks like his strength has increased dramatically. The youth with thick brows ridiculed. The silver-haired youth scorned, it's only silver trash, not worthy enough for me to even lift a finger. The other youth had no comment. Su Yu visited the blacksmith shop and could not help feeling disappointed that all the arrowheads were made of ordinary iron. With 5,000 silver tails in hand, for Su Yu and even the overwhelming majority of the silver students, he held a huge amount of wealth and riches. With nothing to buy, Su Yu looked at himself. Even though his loose and cheap martial robes were clean, the workmanship was crude with no aesthetics to speak of. Although his body was clean, his skin was slightly scruffy, dark and rough. His hair also lacked maintenance, dry and scattered. He looked like an impoverished kid. In Su Yu's former life, he was a white-collar manager who dressed up when he was out, fine and tastefully meticulous in every aspect, not a thread loose or hair out of place. When he came to this world, he born into a poor family and could only endure until now. To Su Yu, who was so accustomed to the fine life, it was not easy. Now that he had money, he had to dress a little bit more respectably. He had shed his former self and been transformed inside. No longer being called useless, the outside also had to be transformed. In this other world, there were similar one-stop beauty services. Sir, we have three kinds of rapid skin improvement spirit serum. The price is quite high, the lowest price is one silver tail per drop. Just apply on the skin, you want a few drops. One silver tail, enough for 1 month of living expenses for ordinary person. Silver students only had one silver tail a month. No one would buy such an expensive spirit serum unless they were wealthy. Get a few drops. Well, get a bucket first and take a bath. Su Yu tilted his head. Ah, a bucket? Oh, yes, very well. Wait a moment, sir. I'll immediately take care of it for you. Sir, hair care spirit serum, there's a collector's edition, please take a look. Bring it all out and use one by one. Ah, yes, yes, very well. Please kindly wait moment, sir. Sir, our clothes are made of the finest silk fabric. There are no better ones. Ah, yes, there is. I'll immediately go to our shop in town and fetch our treasure, a purple dustproof garment. After half a day. Sir, right this way please. This is the mirror, kindly excuse your humble servant. The maid's pretty eyes widened in surprise and she looked at Su Yu with some amazement, finding it somewhat incredible that he had changed beyond recognition. When he came in, she thought he was only a poor and penniless commoner. But now, he looked like a celestial immortal of the highest kind. The contrast between the before and after was so great that even she, who had been in this business for a long time, was shocked. There was never anyone like him, who changed so dramatically that it was like they were two different people. The Divine Nine Dragon Cauldron. Chapter 27. With her many years of experience, she had seen that even if a crow changed into a phoenix, it was still fundamentally a crow on the inside. She had seen too many poor and ignorant people become rich overnight, try to dress themselves up, but still appear to be a fish out of water. But this young noble sir was naturally self-possessed, as if he had the calm and self-confidence of a natural superior. As a result, once he was dressed, everything turned on its head. When Su Yu stood in front of the mirror, he was stunned momentarily. Is this me? Su Yu was astonished. Reflected in the mirror was a tall figure in the luxurious purple garment of a noble youth. A cap of white jade and pearl adorned his head over his ink-black long hair, neat and well-groomed, swinging gracefully at his back. His face was fair like white jade, fine and exquisitely carved, translucent and sparkling as if washed with clear water. A pair of eyes, deep as the galaxy, full of wisdom and calm, sharp nose and cheeks, rosy lips and white teeth, all accentuated each other. As far as the eye could see, it was undoubtedly the jade-carved face of a noble son, radiant with health and vigor, handsome as Adonis. coupled with the luxurious garment which defined his tall build, a projected air of nobility and handsome looks complemented each other well. Su Yu even found the transformation somewhat hard to believe. The foundation of this physical body is very good. It was originally a strong and refined body, but after being trapped in poverty for so long, it's like a pearl obscured by dirt. Now that the dirt is washed away, it is luminous and bright. Su Yu analyzed inwardly. Now, it was unlikely that people could recognize him as the one whose girlfriend was snatched by another, the poor and useless coward, the penniless and lonely Su Yu. When walking, with the dustproof garment lightly fluttering in the breeze, not even a speck dust settled on his whole body. His ink-black hair lightly swayed, accentuating his tall back view. His face was luminous under the sunlight, and indescribably beautiful in the light and shadow. When he was walking on the street, there was a moment of silence in the surroundings. What a handsome young noble son, which aristocratic family does he descend from? Though young in age, such extraordinary bearing. Su Yu lightly chuckled to himself. That smile paired with a handsome face was like a heavenly pearl, bright and brilliant, as if caressed by the spring breeze. As young ladies passed by, they shyly bowed their heads while they stole discreet glances at him, their faces slightly flushed. The bolder ones gazed with charming eyes and flirted with provocative glances. Su Yu smiled as he passed, but only left a fluttering purple shadow as he walked away. Back at the Martial Arts Training Institute, walking within the institute grounds, passers-by repeatedly raised their eyebrows. The male students' faces showed envy and admiration. One look at Su Yu told them that he was from a powerful and wealthy family. The female students were casting flirtatious glances from all directions. Isn't it strange that our institute has such a handsome man, besides Qin Feng and Fan Qingzhu? It seems he's of a noble status too. Strange, he is our classmate, but why have we never seen him before? Su Yu's face wore a light smile all the way through the silver student's dormitory, into his own courtyard. The golden assessment was going to be held in 2 days. As a silver student, he would have the opportunity to initiate a challenge to the gold students. Su Yu only had one goal, which was to defeat Qin Feng. To defeat him on the spot in front of Jiang Zuqing, in front of the world. To tell Jiang Zuqing that her choice to abandon Su Yu was wrong. To tell Qin Feng that his choice to make Su Yu an enemy was also wrong. While passing by the female dormitory, there was a slight commotion on the second floor. Then, a faint cry, a young lady unexpectedly fell from the window, and happened to fall towards Su Yu, head first to the ground. Even if there was strength in her body, she would be seriously injured. Su Yu could not just stand by and watch, and not save her. Using cloud shadow, Su Yu rotated on his toes, graceful like the wind, and leveraged the force to launch into the air. At the right timing, his left hand held her neck, his right hand grabbed hold of her waist, and he carried her in his arms while in the air. Then, they slowly fell gently. The young lady was pale from the fright, her eyes tightly shut. She really thought she was going to be dead. Feeling his strong and warm chest, the young lady slowly opened her eyes. A young noble's face, a head adorned with a cap of white jade and pearl, a pair of eyes deep as the galaxy, so calm, so wise, attracted her so much that she continued to stare. She'd never found that a man could be so good-looking. And the look in his eyes was so appealing. For the first time in her life, her heart started racing for no reason. When a young lady liked someone, it did not need to be everlasting, it did not need sweet talk. Sometimes a look, action, word, or figure, might spark the first awakening of love in her heart. The young lady felt, maybe, she'd met such a man. When she was in a dangerous moment, he appeared. Though no word was spoken, she was still moved. Without an expression on his face, Su Yu put her down and looked up at the second floor window. A figure extended out of the window. Qin Feng. He looked at himself gloomily. Su Yu had just held a woman in his arms that he'd never even touched before. Jiang Zuqing. And Jiang Zuqing, gazing at Su Yu with a dazed look in her eyes, also made Qin Feng feel wrath in his heart. He was compliant to Jiang Zuqing, but Jiang Zuqing was moved by the other man. Not long after, Qin Feng dragged a young lady down with his hands. It was Xuan Lefei, her eyes swollen from crying. She was scared and aggrieved, held by the neck and dragged downstairs by Qin Feng, sobbing and wailing as she went. Thank you, brother, for your kindness in lending a hand. Qin Feng felt that the noble son looked a little familiar, but he could not recall if such a person existed among his aristocratic circle of friends. A deep feeling of threat filled his heart. The other person's face was more handsome, with unparalleled easy confidence and calm, an air of luxury, not weaker than Qin Feng. The most crucial point was that Jiang Zuqing had first awakenings of love. With a hint of hostility, Qin Feng dragged Xuan Lefei away. I'm so sorry, the elixir was snatched by Su Yu. It wasn't intentional, let me go. Xuan Lefei wept like a poor little doll. Qin Feng was chagrined that the matter was not accomplished and demanded for the elixir to be returned, but the 2,500 silver taels worth of elixir had gone missing. Qin Feng had intended to claim back the elixir as a gift for Jiang Zuqing to use for her breakthrough to level 4. Who would have thought that Xuan Lefei insisted the elixir was taken away? Qin Feng was enraged. He wanted to teach her a lesson, but she hurriedly tried to evade him and he inadvertently pushed Jiang Zuqing out of the window. The scene that occurred after made Qin Feng even more distressed, causing him to take his anger out on her. Qin Feng barked, I won't spare you. With Qin Feng's ruthless temper, Xuan Lefei would not have a good ending. Xuan Lefei was terrified, she wept endlessly and looked utterly wretched. She was born poor with no good skills, but carefully circulated among the wealthy to obtain various resources for cultivation. She knew firsthand what it felt like during the periods of sadness. Now that she finally provoked the wrath of Qin Feng, the junior duke, she was isolated and helpless without any power or influence. What kind of elixir did she owe you? Su Yu lightly asked as he stood with his hands behind his back. Qin Feng stopped in his tracks and reluctantly put on a polite face. A top-grade spirit elixir. Is it possible that brother wishes to intervene? Qin Feng had to be polite in his treatment of an honorable noble son of uncommon background. Take it. Su Yu shot out a black box with a snap of his fingers. Such strong fingers. Qin Feng was secretly nervous. In addition to being very handsome and having an aristocratic air, his abilities were very strong too. But Qin Feng, with his level 4 cultivation base, was still able to neutralize this bit of force. Using one hand to catch, he nonchalantly caught the black box, opened to take a look and was shocked to find a top-grade spirit elixir inside. Qin Feng's expression changed. He uttered, Brother, you really want to step in for an unfamiliar woman. Su Yu walked away with his hands behind his back. Without turning his head back, he merely said, Release her. His powerful yet calm voice had a large amount of dignity, as though he had held a high position for a long time. Qin Feng struggled for a moment and actually let go. Jiang Zuqing's beautiful eyes reflected the image of the luxurious and elegant purple garment, the extraordinary splendor of it. He was the world's most magnificent man, getting the spirit elixir, with a value of 2,500 silver taels, so freely and easily, treating money like it was nothing. With her heart moved for the first time, there was yet again another ripple. Thank you, kind sir, for your help. Jiang Zuqing regained herself and gave a bow of respect as she watched him leave. Yep, Su Yu's head did not even turn as he walked away. Qin Feng's expression was ugly. He coldly glared at Jiang Zuqing, What, do you regret being with me? Jiang Zuqing was startled and quickly checked her longing gaze. She guiltily hung her head down. There was a feeling of regret. If only, how wonderful would it be if I could have met him earlier? Jiang Zuqing silently sighed in her heart. To be able to meet the noble sir whom she liked and could give her wealth and status. If only he'd appeared earlier in her life, taken her away from that good-for-nothing Su Yu's side, how perfect would that be? For the first time, Jiang Zuqing felt the unfairness of fate, and felt discontented with Qin Feng. Once, Qin Feng was the most ideal companion she could think of. But until today, having met the noble sir, the instant her heart was moved, she realized she only received materialistic satisfaction from Qin Feng. Her heart did not belong to him. No matter how good Qin Feng was to her, no matter how docile and obedient, it was hard for her to generate any feelings for him. Just as it was with Su Yu, childhood sweethearts, but they were never genuinely moved. Since things had come to this point, she had no choice but to hide her feelings for him. She could not afford to offend Qin Feng's illustrious family. If he were to abandon her and she were to throw herself into the purple-clad noble's arms, an unfathomable fate would await her. Xuan Lefei managed to escape this time, and through hazy tears, gratefully bowed to Su Yu from a distance,
"Many
thanks to you, honorable sir." Su Yu was already far away, the faint voice drifted with the breeze into his ears. The corner of his lips slightly raised, and Su Yu softly murmured, "That was to return you." Her top-grade spirit elixir was originally taken by Su Yu. Back in the courtyard, Su Yu immediately went into seclusion. The golden competition was in 2 days. Su Yu wanted to stand proudly in front of the training institute with his brand new attitude. At the palace of Xianyu Prefecture, in a pink lady's chamber. The young princess of Xianyu, dressed in a duckling yellow dress, was pouting and holding a pillow as she pounded it, puffing with anger. Her small mouth mumbled non-stop, "Wretched father. Doesn't love me one bit. Doesn't love me. I'm going on a hunger strike. I want to antagonize him." A jade white hand lightly swatted her vest as a reminder. "Oh, you. The Duke did it for your own good, being up in the Twilight Mountains, being touched like that. It was indecent. How could the Duke not be angry? Your confinement is for your own good." The voice was soft and gentle, the beautiful face wore a faint smile. It could not be anyone other than the celestial beauty. "Even big sister Jingyu does not help me. I don't want to live, don't want to live." The young princess flopped onto the bed, her two white calves dangling and swaying. The relationship between the palace of Xianyu Prefecture and the Martial Arts Training Institute had always been good. The young princess of Xianyu and Chia Jingyu's ages were similar, about 14 to 15 years old, so both of them got along very well and were good friends who grew up together and told each other everything. The Xianyu young princess's encounter in the Twilight Mountains had left Chia Jingyu blushing with embarrassment after she heard it. The Divine Nine Dragon Cauldron. Chapter 28. The young princess was very unlucky. Contrary to the Duke's reaction, Chia Jingyu showed a little sympathy for the person. That person obviously had good intentions, wanting to save the young princess. Without him, the young princess may have already died from the poison. All things considered, his merit was greater than his wrongdoings. The big fuss made by the Duke about hunting for the person throughout the city seemed over the top. But thinking about it carefully, would any father, knowing that the privacy of his daughter had been violated by a male stranger, not be furious? Associating this with her own experiences in the Twilight Mountains, Chia Jingyu secretly felt relieved. She was lucky that a chivalrous person had helped her in her time of need. He was a righteous person, not taking advantage of her while she was in a coma. She was really lucky indeed. "My niece Jingyu, the information you seek has been found." At this moment, a handsome middle-aged man walked through the door with a warm smile on his face. Chia Jingyu was visibly excited. "Uncle, has my benefactor really been found?" The middle-aged man, who was the Duke, nodded, "Yes. There was a tooth of the fiery lion for sale in the market today. We traced it and within 2 days found out who was the selling the tooth." Chia Jingyu's heart was filled with excitement. All she wanted was to find her benefactor to express her thanks face to face, because without his help, her fate would be hard to determine. Even though that person masked his face, Chia Jingyu was intelligent and deduced that the three explosions during that time were strikingly similar to the tooth of the fiery lion. Unexpectedly, she discovered a clue. Duke Xianyu sighed. News of Chia Jingyu's benefactor arrived instantly, but the vagrant who took advantage of his daughter still could not be found. "Contain your excitement, niece. Even though we found the tooth of the fiery lion, the party selling it might not be the person you are seeking. The other party might be posing as your benefactor, but in reality, eyeing your beauty or wealth. We cannot let our guard down." This was Duke Xianyu's experience speaking. "Do you have another item in your possession to use as collateral with the other party, so as to prevent you from being cheated?" Chia Jingyu hesitated for a moment, then withdrew a fire dragon snakeskin armor from her arms. "All I have is this. It was left behind by the chivalrous man." The smile on Duke Xianyu's face froze a little. The young princess was less forgiving. She wrinkled her nose and muttered, "Who made that armor? It's hideous." Duke Xianyu toned down the strange look on his face. His eyes sparkled. "Could I get someone to look into the armor and start searching for more information? We might find more clues." Chia Jingyu gladly agreed. A servant had a spark of inspiration. He took the armor to the sheet of fire dragon snakeskin collected recently to compare them, then with a dramatic change in expression rushed to give the Duke a report. My Duke, it's the same snakeskin. The servant was visibly excited. The Duke had spent upwards of a month trying to capture this person, and today there was finally a clue. Even though the servants did not understand why the Duke and the young princess desperately wanted to capture this person, they imagined that this person had committed some unpardonable crime. The eyes of the Duke flared with fury, inform the others. All black armor guards are to pursue the source of the fiery lion. Roger. Rumble. From within the Duke's abode rushed a large group of black armor guards, full of bloodlust, initiating a manhunt within the city. Unaware of the perils that were about to occur, Su Yu let out a long howl. Ha ha ha. It is finally done. Su Yu's purple robe billowed, his black hair danced in the wind. His powerful aura blanketed the surroundings. The maids that were cleaning in the courtyard started shivering profusely. Their feelings of fear were difficult to suppress, given how powerful Su Yu's aura was. Level 4 martial arts. Finally succeeded after consuming the marrow of hellfire. But the bigger achievement was Su Yu's enlightenment regarding the wall paintings the elder pointed to. For 2 days, while his body was practicing martial arts, his mind was concentrated on the wall paintings. Su Yu's 2 days was equivalent to 40 days for another person. Su Yu could draw understanding from a heavenly scroll. Even though he could only understand, but not make use of, the ability as of now, he believed that once he succeeded in casting the ability, its power would be overwhelming. Furthermore, in these 2 days, Su Yu had completed Tier 2 of the technique Tempest. Now, a simple kick by him could bring out a billow of white fog. The fog would be overbearingly cold, and would serve him well in close combat. He had also completed his light body cultivation cloud shadow technique. He had understood the entirety of the technique in the manual. In terms of technique and speed, he had reached the peak of level 4, and was now breaking through to level 5. Being level 4 in terms of martial arts, his body gathered vital energy, the first of what he could call his own. Using this vital energy to cast his various tricks allowed their powers rise up a tier. Ding ding ding. The sound of distant bells reverberated through the morning light. The gathering sounds of the golden selection test had finally begun. Compared to the silver selection test, the golden selection test was the true major event for martial arts training institutes. There were 100 gold class students, representing the overall strength of the martial arts training institutes. Today, not only would Master Fu and Master Yi make an appearance, the elusive Grand Master, of martial arts level 7, would also be attending. Upon hearing the bells, the students, gold class and silver class, congregated towards the contest hall. Su Yu stood up, his purple robe billowing in the wind, his eyes, like stars, glowed intensely. Qin Feng, I, Su Yu, am coming. The contest hall was the same one used in the silver selection test. Only this time, not everyone could enter. No entry for silver class students under rank 100. At the entrance of the contest hall stood two large guards of martial arts level 4, announcing the rule. This had always been the case in the past, but the silver class students were still disappointed. The silver class students above the rank 100 entered the hall after proudly showing their tokens. Su Yu elegantly came forward. His luxurious vibe and handsome looks, likened to celestial beings shown in paintings, was awe-inspiring to onlookers. The crowd naturally gave way to him, giving him curious looks. Identify yourself, the two large guards grunted. Su Yu whipped out his token and flashed it for a moment before proceeding into the hall. The two guards could not even stop him in time. Did you recognize who that was? If I am not mistaken, isn't that? The two guards could not continue. They could not believe what they had just witnessed. Su Yu, the top of the silver class students, looks like that. Didn't the rumors say that he was a poor student? The two guards looked at each other as if they had just seen a ghost. The silver class students outside the contest hall were equally shocked. Hey, who exactly was that man in purple? I saw him holding a token for silver class students. I saw it too, but do we really have such a refined, elegant man amongst our ranks? The crowd looked around at each other. Su Yu entered the hall. While the contest hall could hold an audience of 10,000 people, only 200 were allowed in today. 100 silver class students, and 100 gold class. Su Yu had arrived relatively late. They had all congregated near the central stage, occupying the front rows. The contest had not begun, as only the judges and the gold class students preparing for the contest had arrived. The higher-ranked officials within the institute had not yet arrived. Coincidentally, the presiding judge of the contest was still Minister Jiang. His martial arts were at the peak of level 4, and he had terrifying abilities. Su Yu thought back to the day when Minister Jiang underhandedly attempted to severely wound him in the contest for the top of the silver class. Su Yu would keep this event etched in his mind. "I, Su Yu, have not forgotten this hatred, you old thing." Su Yu's gaze turned ice cold. Minister Jiang scanned the crowd and confirmed that the students had more or less arrived. After the gold selection test, silver class students have the right to issue a challenge to the gold class students of their corresponding rank. Gold class students can also do the same towards the silver class students, Minister Jiang said coolly. For example, the current top of the gold class can issue a challenge to the top of the silver class, and vice versa. Minister Jiang stepped on a random spot on the stage, which seemed to be hiding some sort of mechanism. The ground rumbled and three stone pillars, each 5 meters tall, slowly rose from the ground. Standing on the stone pillars, one could overlook every corner of the stage, making it the best place for spectating the contest. Out of all who are present here, only the top three can obtain a seat on the pillar. Those who do are given priority in choosing the person they want to challenge. What he meant was that as long as a student could obtain one of the three seats atop the stone pillars, he would have the priority in choosing who he wanted to challenge after the gold selection test was over. If Su Yu could get hold of a seat, then he could be the one initiating the challenge to Qin Feng, and he would not have to wait to be challenged himself. The seats belong to the ones with the strongest abilities. "Let the contest begin," Minister Jiang announced. The silver class students did not dare move, gazing with admiration at the 100 gold class students competing for the spots. Su Yu's eyes sparkled with electricity, his black hair danced. His purple robe flew with the wind, leaving only a purple trail within the crowd. "What speed? Who is the person in purple? Quick, look there, who exactly is the man in purple?" Pow pow. Anywhere Su Yu went, people were beaten down. Surprised howls could be heard everywhere. Su Yu's speed was at the peak of level 4, no one could contest him. With his purple robe still flowing, Su Yu was the first to reach the top of a stone pillar, obtaining a seat for himself. "Which bastard is blind enough to steal my spot on the tower?" A muscular teenager raised his head and scolded. Below Su Yu's pillar was a mob of angry students, each trying to climb up and challenge Su Yu for his spot. Scram! Su Yu's nostrils gently flared, his powerful level 4 aura blanketing the arena. Level 4. The rude, muscular teen was taken aback. He was ranked 5th amongst the gold class students, with martial arts at the peak of level 3, but he knew that in the face of a level 4 master, his abilities were not worth mentioning. The area below Su Yu's pillar suddenly became quiet. Level 4. He was actually level 4. Who exactly is he? Besides Qin Feng and Fang Qingzhu of the gold class students, there's a third level 4 master. Also, have you ever seen this person? Is he even from our institute? Why haven't I seen him before? He had powerful and terrifying abilities, coupled with a suave, handsome appearance and noble, calm temperament. Why had no one ever heard of such an excellent person? The silver class students looked around at each other, all finding this gold class student in the purple robe familiar, but they could not identify him if their lives depended on it. Jiang Zuqing sat amongst the silver class students, her dainty hands rubbing her chin, eyes listlessly gazing at the floor. At times she giggled, at times she became shy, and at other times she became frustrated. It had started 2 days ago, when she had visions that she could not shake of a purple shadow. She could not forget those star-like eyes. Would I see him again? Even if it's just once, to thank him. Jiang Zuqing lightly sighed. Hearing the commotion around her, Jiang Zuqing lifted her gaze and followed the direction they were pointing. What she saw was a familiar purple figure. The tall, slender physique and an air of pompousness, suave as a celestial being in a painting, and etched in her mind, those star-like eyes. It's the purple-robed prince. Jiang Zuqing exclaimed while covering her mouth. Her beautiful eyes shone with excitement. It's him. It's really him. In those 2 days, she had frequently looked forward to meeting him again,
many times
even going to the spot where she saw the purple flash. Unfortunately, her wish had not been granted. Her maiden heart was thumping away, and Jiang Zuqing's eyes were now unable to shift away from his figure. The Divine Nine Dragon Cauldron. Chapter 29. At that moment, all she wanted to know was the name of the person who had stolen her heart for the first time. There were three individuals in the corner of the arena. Chia Jingyu, a silver-haired youth, and a youth with thick brows and big eyes quietly sat in the corner. Master Jingyu, who is the youth in the purple robe? Why haven't I heard of him if he is level 4 of the martial path? I believe I have seen all the gold students above rank 10, the youth with thick brows said, a perplexed look on his face. Chia Jingyu, with a mystified look on her face said, it's really weird, I do not recognize him either. I'm fairly certain that he is not a gold student. Still, Chia Jingyu could not shake the feeling that she had seen this purple-robed youth in the past. However, she could not associate this person with any other nobles that she recognized. The silver-haired youth's face flooded with contempt, you're still garbage. The appearance of this purple-robed youth had sparked a small riot. No one in the audience recognized him. He had everyone thoroughly puzzled. In fact, there were some who suspected that he was a student from another institution and had snuck into the hall. Where do you think this youth is from? He looks really good, spoke a candid girl, putting her gaze on Su Yu. I'm so embarrassed, said a shy girl, averting her gaze, only daring to sneak peeks at him. His remarkable ability, handsome appearance and aura of nobility was enough to steal many girls' hearts. There were two light thuds to the side of Su Yu. Both Qin Feng and Fang Qingzhu secured their place on the other stone pillars, albeit slightly slower than Su Yu. The two were undoubtedly the strongest participants and naturally had no contest for their spots on the stone pillar. The three with the best abilities had shown themselves and had taken their rightful spots on the pillars. Qin Feng's pupils dilated, his hostility faintly discernible. He knew why Jiang Zuqing had been so distracted for the past 2 days. All she could think about was this mysterious purple-robed youth. I am Qin Feng. May I know your name? Qin Feng saluted politely, cupping hands, for the other party was after all a strong level 4. Su Yu did not meet his gaze, sat down and calmly replied, your old friend. My old friend, Qin Feng could not recall for the life of him a friend that had ability, looks and disposition equal to him. Fang Qingzhu, with a perplexed look on his face, measured up Su Yu, then asked, I have not seen you in the past. Did you sneak in here from another institute? Su Yu did not answer. From what he had observed, Fang Qingzhu carried himself like an oaf. Saying even one word to this kind of person would only sully himself. HMPH, you dare to be this arrogant in front of me. Fine. After the contest, we'll see exactly how deep your abilities go. Fang Qingzhu shot him a furious glare. His gaze subconsciously drifted to another corner and stopped on a beautiful figure. A tinge of regret flashed past his eyes, but was soon replaced by a boiling anger. Do not let me find out who you are. Qin Feng clenched his fists, his anger clearly visible. If it wasn't him who charged out and saved Chia Jingyu, he would have had her. Even her corpse would do. Jiang Zixi curiously glanced up at Su Yu a few times, and had a rising suspicion that they had met, but could not associate him with anybody he knew. Rumble. A commotion was heard through the doors of the contest hall. Three remarkable men, under the gaze of the students, teachers and management, slowly stepped into the contest hall. Amongst them was Lord Yi, head of discipline. Su Yu owed him a favor. However, Lord Yi was walking at the back of the group with a stern look on his face, solemnly and cautiously trailing the person in front. The person was gentle and elegant, with thin sleek brows on a handsome face. He was dressed in a long white robe and had flowing black hair. While he seemed gentle, his disposition inspired awe. He was the lord of the Xianyu Prefecture Martial Arts Training Institute, Qia Lingxuan. His abilities had reached an incredible martial path level 7 and was a living legend, unparalleled in the world. The students peering at him were overcome with admiration. Qia Lingxuan, the living legend. He was the lifetime goal of countless students. However, Chia Lingxuan was not the one walking at the very front. The person at the very front was also an attractive middle-aged man, with narrow, long eyes that emanated a cold gaze. There was an arrogant aura surrounding him, and even a person as powerful as Chia Lingxuan was not worth mentioning to him. He was strikingly similar to Fang Qingzhu. Atop the stone pillar, a smile crept across Fang Qingzhu's face. Qin Feng, on the contrary, displayed both fear and respect. At that moment, he did not dare breathe atop his pillar. The three men took their seats. Fang Qingzhu's father, Fang Yun, was undoubtedly seated in the center of the seats reserved for honored guests. Lord Chia Lingxuan and Lord Yixuan were seated beside him. Su Yu, with a sparkle in his eyes, asked, "Is that Fang Qingzhu's father? Or uncle, who is he to have such an esteemed position?" He had never seen anything outside the Xianyu prefecture. In Su Yu's eyes, the Xianyu prefecture was vast and had many talented people flocking to join. The strongest person he knew would be the lord of the institute, the legendary Chia Lingxuan. However, now that he had seen Fang Yun, he knew that the world outside was indeed more vast. Chia Lingxuan looked towards Jiang Zixi and stroked his chin. Jiang Zixi straightened his posture and, with a stern look, solemnly announced, "The golden assessment officially begins." The golden assessment was more or less the same as the silver assessment. All the gold students would be split into 10 groups based according to their rank, and then would compete to be the strongest in their group. Thereafter, those who were victorious would compete to be ranked in the top 10, and finally the grand final would be fought for the title of the Gold King. A month ago, Su Yu would have been unimaginably excited to witness the golden assessment. However, now that he had become stronger, this excitement was waning. 3 hours later, the group stages were over, and the top 10 students were realized. On the podium, Chia Lingxuan gently asked, "Inspector Fang, what do you think of the abilities of the students in this batch?" Fang Yun arrogantly scanned the remaining 10 students, finally placing his gaze on his son, Fang Qingzhu. He showed a hint of a smile, "They're acceptable." Chia Lingxuan laughed lightly. Yixuan, on the other hand, secretly heaved a sigh of relief. "We managed to tide through this year," Yixuan thought to himself. Fang Yun was from the sanctuary, and his job was to inspect the teaching situation here in the Martial Arts Training Institute. He could represent the sanctuary and punish the management of the institute should the abilities and talents of the current batch of students be too weak. Fang Yun was only also level 7 of the martial path, with abilities equal to the lord of the institute. But Fang Yun was from the sanctuary, and was assisting the sanctuary in inspecting the institute. In terms of authority, the lords paled in comparison. In the eyes of a layman, a martial arts training institute should be a place where talents gather, and should ride above the royal power. However, not many know that the martial arts training institutes are but a branch of the sanctuary. The leader of the sanctuary, the Holy King, was dedicated to the cultivation of talents of the world, and thus established martial arts training institutes in each of the 13 prefectures of the Fenglin Empire. He also dispatched 13 inspectors to help him check on the teaching processes in them. Should there be any lapses, punishment would definitely ensue. There was an incident where the management of a martial arts training institute used resources that were provided for the students for personal use, halting the progress of an entire generation of students. Once the inspector got wind of this, everyone in the management, from the lords to the ministers, were executed on the spot. Inspector Fang, in theory, held the power to execute everyone in the management, for he represents the sanctuary. Today, Fang Yun was here to gauge the abilities of this batch of students. Upon hearing Fang Yun's approval, many from the crowd heaved a sigh of relief, for it meant that they had passed the inspection. The contest between the top 10 had begun. Fang Qingzhu and Qin Feng were still dominating the competition. Being level 4s, they defeated their competitors in 3 moves. The two advanced steadily, and had finally reached the semi-final. Fang Qingzhu was paired against the 6th-ranked gold student. Continuous 8 trigram finger. Fang Qingzhu let out a low grunt as he displayed a medium-level cultivation technique. Pop pop pop. In just 3 hits, his opponent vomited blood and was defeated. Chia Lingxuan was impressed. "The continuous 8 trigram finger technique is a medium-level cultivation technique and has overwhelming power, but requires the user to have a high level of insight.
Your son, being able to attain stage 2 of this technique, has a high level of insight.
Fang Yun was immensely proud of his son, but put on a show of humility, gently shaking his head. King Zhu's attitude towards his training regimen is not optimal, and he will not get very far. In the midst of admiration from countless girls, Fang King Zhu coolly returned to his stone pillar, then shot a provocative look towards Qin Feng.
Hey hey, Qin Feng, I heard that you wanted to claim the title of the Gold King.
Let's see how far your abilities can get you. Try not to embarrass yourself in front of that girlfriend of yours. Talking about Jiang Zuqing, Fang King Zhu could not help but glance in her direction, a bolt of passion flaring from his eyes. Jiang Zuqing was one of the top 3 beauties, and he wanted her as a girlfriend, but was beaten to it by Qin Feng. He could not afford to offend the son of Duke Qin, and thus had to drop the idea. Qin Feng forced a smile, but did not dare talk back to the mockery. His father, Fang Yun, was too much of a presence. Qin Feng's entire family could not hold a candle to him. The term, sanctuary, had determined everything. Qin Feng's popularity was also very high, with many people cheering for him as he made his way down to the stage. His innate talent, remarkable ability, suave appearance and family background were all criteria for a teenage girl's perfect lover. Jiang Zuqing was one of the rare few that did not look over at Qin Feng. She had not shifted her gaze since the appearance of the purple-robed youth. Even though she was a pragmatic person, she was but a youth. It was fine if her heart was not moved, but once it was, it went deep down to her bones. Qin Feng wore a solemn expression. His opponent was ranked 5th amongst the gold students, and was the one competing with Su Yu for the spot on the stone pillar.
Monumental Buddha's palm, Qin Feng exclaimed, his palm slicing the air, causing a series of small explosions in the air.
The opponent dropped to the ground with just one strike, spewing blood as he slipped into a coma. Qia Lingxuan showed surprise. Qin Feng's improvement was monumental. To think he already broke through the upper tier of level 4. The Monumental Buddha's palm technique is not a skill we teach in the institute. He must have gotten the manual from the Qin family. To attain stage 2 of the same medium-level fighting style with such explosive power, Qin Feng's level of insight must also be rather high. His gaze wavered. Qia Lingxuan had cut his explanation short in order to save Fang Yun some face. In terms of power, the Monumental Buddha's palm and the continuous 8 trigram finger were considered equal. However, fighting styles exist to counter each other, and should the Buddha's palm and the 8 trigram finger be pitted against each other at equal strength, Qin Feng would have the advantage. Fang Yun creased his eyebrows, refusing to comment. Su Yu's eyes contracted. Qin Feng had actually achieved the upper tier of level 4, and was an equal to Fang King Zhu. Finally, Su Yu's face displayed his burning battle spirit. Defeating Qin Feng as he is now would prove to be much more meaningful. No matter how strong you become, Qin Feng, I, Su Yu, will ultimately catch up to you. Jiang Zixi solemnly announced, the contest for the title of Gold King begins now. Qin Feng against Fang King Zhu. The golden assessment had finally entered its final phase. The Divine Nine Dragon Cauldron. Chapter 30. With an imposing look, Fang King Zhu leapt down from his stone pillar, measuring up Qin Feng with his eyes. He scorned, to think you actually managed to break through. Your abilities have indeed improved. Qin Feng scanned the crowd for the lone Jiang Zuqing, his gaze resolute. He had promised that he would use the honor of the title, Gold King, to become engaged to her. He had trained diligently for the past month, with excellent results. With a slight nod, Qin Feng took his stance, come at me. Brother Fang, the title Gold King belongs to me. You are not worthy. Fang King Zhu scolded. How could he let somebody take away what was rightfully his? Continuous 8 trigram finger. Fang King Zhu's body moved as weightlessly as a shadow, speedily advancing towards Qin Feng. His fingers, dexterous as a dragon, traced the pattern of the 8 trigrams with incredible speed. The unpredictable changes, fading in and out of reality, concealed an immense power, unfathomable to the layman. Qin Feng's expression turned tense. Monumental Buddha's palm. The winds emanating from his palms were fierce, and the air crackled with every slight movement of his hands. The wind circled his palms as if they were a breath of fury waiting to be released. A collision of palm and finger. The two took a step back, victor undecided.
Fang Qingzhu's expression turned serious. The title of Gold King is mine. Who dares take it away from me? Chia Lingxu increased his eyebrows at the sight of such arrogant and barbaric howls. Fan Qinzu had long looked up to his father's might, but was arrogant and boorish. To threaten his opponent into losing was despicable indeed. Unfortunately, Qin Feng was no commoner, but a junior duke. The title belongs to the one with the best ability. If you wish to protect the title, you will have to best me in battle. Qin Feng was undeterred, facing Fang Qingzhu head-on. Fang Qingzhu was livid, and started exchanging fists with Qin Feng. Rumble. Their abilities were nearly identical, and the victor was not decided even after 80 rounds of sparring. Fang Qingzhu grew increasingly anxious, spewing out roars of anger. However, Qin Feng was indifferent. In terms of status, they were identical. Qin Feng saw no need to be overly cautious of Fang Qingzhu. As time went by, Qin Feng gradually gained the upper hand. Finger techniques were naturally disadvantageous against the more forceful palm techniques. This, coupled with his impetuous nature, meant Qin Feng had already led his opponent to an inevitable defeat. Qin Feng timed his attack, striking his palm into the gap of Fang Qingzhu's defense, leaving an imprint on his chest. Ah! Fang Qingzhu wailed in agony and flew off the stage. He, Gold King of the previous generation, had been completely defeated. Contempt flashed past the eyes of Fang Yun, but he could not act on it due to his reputation and status. Garbage. Reflect on yourself after you get back. After the chiding, Fang Yun calmly said to Chia Lingxuan, you've raised this batch of students pretty well. After which, Fang Yun rose, preparing to leave. Chia Lingxuan gently smiled, why not finish watching before you leave? The rest of the competition might improve your mood. After a pause, Fang Yun returned to his seat, inadvertently looking at the stage. Jiang Zixi had a smile on his face, placing the crown of the Gold King onto Qin Feng. Congratulations. Qin Feng was drained to the bone. He took a few deep breaths before gazing towards Jiang Zuching. The title of the Gold King. He had obtained it. However, his smile froze. In his moment of glory, the person he loved had not paid any attention to him, and instead was mesmerized by the mysterious purple-robed youth. Qin Feng exploded with anger, shooting furious glares at Su Yu. Judge, the Gold King has the right to challenge a person of his choice, am I right? Qin Feng's eyes blazed with hatred, never once shifting his gaze from Su Yu. Regardless of the identity of the purple-robed youth, anybody who stole the heart of his lover was an enemy. The garbage Su Yu could wait, for he still had the right to challenge someone a second time. Jiang Zixi nodded. Fine. I want to challenge him. Qin Feng had issued his challenge, pointing at the lone purple-robed youth atop his stone pillar. A commotion broke out in the hall. This purple-robed youth had left him perplexed. His identity was shrouded in mystery. No one would have thought that the junior duke's first challenge would be issued towards him. Jiang Zixi also had a confused look on his face. That person was familiar, but he could not figure out why. Su Yu slowly opened his star-like eyes. From atop, he gazed at Qin Feng, coolly speaking, challenge me after you rest up. Otherwise, there is no honor in me winning. Qin Feng was exhausted, and his ability was not even at 70% of his normal level. There is no need for your concern. The battle spirit in Qin Feng's heart was ignited. Only by defeating the purple-robed youth in front of Jiang Zuqing could he dispel the hatred in his heart. He withdrew a precious elixir from his robes and consumed it. After which he felt his fatigue dissipate, his strength and vitality gradually returned to him. You live up to your name as a junior duke. You took a recovery elixir worth 1,000 taels without hesitation. Qin Feng's eyes were filled with fury, battle me. Su Yu's purple robe billowed, his hair dancing in the wind. His suave face brightened up. He let out a small whisper from his lips. I have awaited this day for far too long. Whoosh. The purple figure was like the wind. It was like a cloud's shadow, faintly there, but also likened to the calm waves of a river, graceful as anything. Chia Lingxuan let out a look of surprise, the peak of stage 3 of the cloud shadow trick. There are other students, other than the 10 great demon students with their monstrous levels of insight, who could completely learn it. Yixuan, who is this person? His cultivation is of level 4 lower tier of the martial paths, why haven't we heard of him? Xuanhuan was equally lost. He seems familiar, but I do not know who he is exactly.
Chia Lingxuan's face showed a hint of surprise. He could not help but laugh. Interesting. This battle might not be as simple as a sideshow to lift the mood.
Graceful as a swan, Su Yu made his way to the stage. He stood with his hands behind his back, calmly locked in a deep gaze.
Jiang Zixi could not comprehend the person in front of him. He politely said, "You can choose to decline the challenge if you wish to. He is the Gold King and by accordance can only challenge the Silver King."
Su Yu said calmly, "I have been waiting for this match for a long time. How can I decline this challenge?"
"All right, the Gold King against the purple-robed youth. The contest begins."
Jiang Zixi had forgotten to ask for the name of the other party.
Qin Feng's cold eyes were laced with arrogance. He glanced over to Jiang Zuqing, only to find that her gaze was still fixed on the purple-robed youth. In fact, her eyes were filled with the expectation of the purple-robed youth's victory.
Qin Feng developed an intent to kill. He was her boyfriend, and this position had been threatened by a complete stranger.
Monumental Buddha's palm. Qin Feng angrily struck out, pushing his vital energy and stamina to their limits. His palm was like the wind, vigorous and hurried.
Su Yu was calm, moving as a purple flash.
Tempest. He gathered a wave of frost by lifting his leg. The white frost appeared suddenly, wrapping around his leg. He took advantage of the frost and struck out.
Qin Feng retreated 3 meters, and Su Yu, 2.5.
Qin Feng gasped, hurriedly shaking away the frost that had gathered on his palm, a look of surprise showing on his face.
"You learned Tempest."
Qin Feng could not believe it. Hidden in the second level of the depository of Buddhist scriptures was a famous leg technique that was notoriously difficult to gain insight to. It was said that it was the most difficult technique to attain within the entire second level. There were many that tried to gain insight, including Qin Feng. But none of them succeeded. The fact that this purple-robed youth had managed to attain the technique was indeed shocking.
Chia Lingxuan's eyes brightened up. "Xuanhuan, please run a check to see if this person is from our institute.
At such a young age, he managed to gain insight into stage 2 of Tempest. With his level of insight, it wouldn't even be wrong to place him with the demon students."
Xuanhuan deeply nodded, his eyes shone with curiosity.
Su Yu smiled, but he did not speak. He closed the gap and began his attack on Qin Feng. The two figures nimbly interlaced.
Rumble.
At times his palm sliced the wind, and at others the kick brought the frost. The battle between the two was overwhelming. Unknowingly, the spectators were on their feet, looking on at the battle in awe. The onlookers were unable to comprehend when such an imposing master had appeared in the institute. A pot of tea was finished. The two were still locked in combat, exchanging moves for no less than 30 rounds. The onlooking Jiang Zixi was deep in shock. He was also at the level 4 peak of the martial path, and the standard of battle between the two was strikingly close to that.
Jiang Zuqing was gazing intently, her breath hurried. Her chest repeatedly palpitated, following the purple figure with her eyes. Her dainty fists were tightly clenched, her maiden heart thumping wildly.
Too strong.
Comparable to Qin Feng.
Great. 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 There was still a hidden gem in my institute.
Chia Lingxuan was visibly elated.
From the spectators' stand, the three celestial beings were watching with great interest.
This is really weird. Who exactly is the purple-robed youth?
The thick-browed youth scratched his head.
The curiosity was killing him. The difficulty of Tempest is comparable to advanced-level leg techniques, but he had managed to attain it.
A person of this level of insight is comparable to us 10 great demon students.
Who can tell me where exactly this guy came from?
The celestial being gazed at their visibly elated father, sharing his joy. Her father would only be happy when there was another genius in his institute, and she was happy when her father was.
The silver-haired youth wrinkled his brows slightly, gently flaring his nostrils. "That is nothing amazing.
He would still be crushed in my hands."
Atop the stage.
Rumble.
As time passed, the difference in abilities were made more apparent.
Qin Feng gradually could not keep up, his entire body covered in frost.
His brows, hair, bare arms and face were pale white.
"I will not lose."
Qin Feng let out an angry roar, fully utilizing his vital energy and stamina, using up all 18 manners of his auxiliary cultivation techniques. On the contrary, Su Yu's expression remained calm, as if he was still water in an autumn pond. From the beginning, Su Yu had only used Tempest, never once employing his other techniques. Rumble. Finally, Qin Feng could no longer keep up with Su Yu's leg technique, and was kicked in the face. He landed outside the stage, spewing a stream of blood from his mouth. Qin Feng was defeated. After 50 rounds, he was finally defeated. He had lost his first battle as this batch's Gold King. Su Yu calmed the disorder amongst the crowd, walking to the edge of the stage with his arms behind his back. From his vantage point, all he saw was the bloodied Qin Feng. "You are too weak. You really disappointed me," Su Yu loosely said. He had defeated the person who stole his girlfriend. The person who had tried to frame him multiple times. The person he had resolved to defeat. However, Su Yu did not feel any sense of accomplishment. In the past, Qin Feng was the biggest hurdle he could imagine. However, the battle today was too easy. He had not displayed his vital energy. This kind of victory could not give birth to any sense of accomplishment. Jiang Zuqing's beautiful eyes exuded radiance. Her hands rubbed her lips in disbelief. This purple-robed prince was even more powerful than Qin Feng. The line, "You are too weak," caused her maiden heart to thump uncontrollably. The purple-robed youth was too powerful. The Gold King, in his eyes, was only worth the words, "too weak." At this moment, the purple-robed youth was deeply etched in her heart. Her youthful maiden heart was totally captivated. The crowd gasped. This mysterious purple-robed youth was unbelievably powerful. The Gold King was too weak. In that moment, the crowd became unbearingly curious. Who in the Institute could be this powerful? Qin Feng was defeated, and the knot in his heart was untied. Su Yu gazed over the horizon, unable to shake the feeling that he was but a tiny speck, and his ability was not enough. Qin Feng was but the son of Duke Qin. The Qin family's influence was not worth mentioning. Jiang Zixi's face emanated awe. He cautiously and politely stepped forward, and with cupped hands asked, "If I may, what is your name?" This question silenced the entire hall.